With an experience, Smriti Rani, are you ready with your speech?
Yes, sir, yes.
Go ahead.
Sir, these so-called people who call it unconstitutional did not have a problem when the Indian constitution was not even applicable in Jammu and Kashmir. First of all, Article 370 gives temporary provision to the state. And next, this keeping of Article 370 compromises on the superiority and the sovereignty of the Indian Parliament. Should a dog wag a tail, in a very colloquial terms, should a dog wag a tail or a tail wag a dog? Indian Parliament should be able to make decision for them. And not even that, sir, this whole argument is baseless, because RPI Act, they won't even read to that. CAG, Controller and Auditor General, is not there in Jammu and Kashmir before, okay, before abrogation. Central Vigilance Com was not even there. Corruption was at its level best, sir. Loot for the last 70 years by the two families ruling there. And not just that, not even political reservation for the backward and the marginalized section was there in Jammu and Kashmir. No right to education, which is a breakage of Article 21, by the way. And abolition of child marriage was also not even there before abrogation of 370. IPC is not applicable. They have some Ranbir penal code, not IPC. Then, not just that, sir, at the most, I would like to say that Article 370 is anti-development, anti-poor, anti-woman, and anti-Dalit.
Yeah,
sir, last, I'll just conclude with one line. Can I say that? Yeah, sir, in parliamentary debate, in the real parliamentary debate, nobody was able to give us a response to us. When BJP put it forward, we had reasons why we want to abrogate it. Nobody was able to give a reply except for the Prime Minister of Pakistan, Zia-ul-Haq. Nobody else gave a response to that.
Thank you so much, Farooq Abdullah. Go ahead, just speak.
Smriti Rani, you have the floor for the next.
May I start now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. So, Hindutva is an intellectual, political, social response by the Hindus to prevent itself and themselves from aggression. That is a basic definition by Veer Savarkar. See, therefore, Hindutva cannot be dominating, because Hindutva itself has been a victim of aggression. This must be something which has to be cleared at the very outset. Hindutva cannot be aggressive, it is defensive. And the primary philosophy of the BJP or the Jan Sangh has been to see the country and the motherland raised to the level of its true potential, whether it may be economic, spiritual, military, or anything. One may choose to call it cultural nationalism or Hindutva. That the real Hindu Hriday Samrat is Narendra Modi ji himself, and under his prime ministership, one child could not, that child should not feel cringe to say that I am a Hindu. He can say with pride. And Atal Bihari ji, I would like to conclude my words by saying that Hindutva in one word is Hindu tan mane Hindu jeevan rag rag Hindu mera parichay, in one word. You can flaunt your Hindu identity and the Bharatiya identity without any fear. That's it, sir. That's Hindutva for me.
Thank you, Smriti Rani ji.